visibility or a blocking of visibility in these paintings that people try to, you know, search for answers to. But I'm also interested here in how this could also be seen as having a political complexion that's not just the artist's self-expression or those other things. And so I want to start with, I'm just going to throw the theory out there now, and then I'm going to just talk about the paintings. And I, like Chris, I want you to work it out for me later. So I'm interested in this idea of parallax vision, and particularly point of view. And I'm also interested how, in the Sublime Object of Ideology by Žižek, he really starts off with Althusser and the notion of interpolation. And I think this is quite interesting for Rothko, and I don't know if I'll persuade you or not. But if we think of the concept of interpolation, this was discussed by Hilary Noroni in the previous talk I went to, it's very much, okay, you've got a political system, you've got a social system, but how do you situate yourself within that? How does it call out to you? So it's this kind of process of stitching you into that so that you feel beholden to it, so that you somehow identify yourself. Like when the law says you can't do this, you think, okay, that means I can't do this. Now, this may seem a little far afield, but also think here of Lacan and the mirror phase, which is kind of very tightly related, very closely related to the sort of theme of interpolation, insofar as it's about how, you know, the simple thing, for a while when you're an infant, you look in a mirror and you don't see yourself, and then you look in a mirror and you do see yourself. And I think it's very interesting here that Lacan always says that's a moment of misrecognition, like that's actually not you. You know, but we are socialized to identify our face, our name, and sort of stitch those together. So there are two points of reference. So I don't think I'll go to Žižek, though perhaps we can come back to that later. But I do want to think about this sort of notion of point of view and how it's implicated in politics, and also what was going on with the Seagram murals themselves and what Rothko was thinking about. And I came across, I just checked this today, he gave a talk at Pratt Institute in 1958, just before he started making these paintings. And he goes on and talks that I'm not interested really in self-expression. I don't think art's about freedom. And he also very insistently says it's not about me, it's not, you know, he sort of detests self-expression in